Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the International Military Student Office, in partnership with the Command and General Staff College and Army University, thank you for joining us today for our fourth presentation of our Know Your World Cultural Engagement Series for the class of 2023. First, a couple of announcements. If during the presentation your child or spouse becomes unruly, please do take them to the atrium until they're ready to return. If you have any electronic devices, please silence them at this time. After the presentation, please join the presenter and her family at the formal reception area in the atrium to sample authentic Moroccan cuisine, to receive a small gift and do a small craft, and also thank the presenter for all the work that she put into this presentation. We look forward to seeing you all there. At this time, it is my honor and privilege to present to you from the Moroccan Royal Armed Forces Corps Logistique, Major Hind, Jirari. This is Know Your World, Morocco.
Good afternoon. Mesa El Khair, Timmy Sweenin, bonsoir. Buenas tardes. Msa l-kher alikum. Yes, we do speak all these languages in Morocco. First, I would like to thank you all for taking your precious time to attend Know Your World Morocco. This event could not occur without your presence, the support of the IMSG office, my student ambassador, my awesome subgroup 13 Alpha, not to forget my instructors, my international colleagues, my mom and dad who are watching me right now from Morocco, and my adorable children, Rania and Amin. It's an immense pleasure and honor to share with you today a piece of the Moroccan heritage and surprising cosmopolitan culture. But before I dive into the agenda, let me ask you some simple questions. It's not the M300 quiz, and it's not graded. Well, how many of you have heard about Morocco? Cool. So, one second question. How many of you know where is it? Great. Very good starting from me, thanks God. I feel more confident and I can begin my presentation by sweeping some misconceptions and highlighting incredible facts you may not probably know about Morocco. Morocco is all desert, where Jasmine and Aladdin live. I'm sorry to disappoint you, it's not entirely true. People still believe that Morocco is made up of desert and nothing else, and that Moroccans ride camels to travel from one place to another, or even to go to school. However, when visitors dig deeper into Morocco, they get surprised because the landscape is very diverse. All men wear jellaba and fez hats, and all women wear a scarf. It's again false. Men wear jellaba for prayer and some special occasion, and not all women wear a scarf. Morocco is one of the most liberal Muslim countries, following doctrine Malikir. The population is very cosmopolitan, and Moroccans are open-minded and tolerant. In Morocco, we celebrate three new years. Yes, this is true. Morocco is a land of many festivals and holidays. We celebrate the Islamic New Year, Fatih Muharram. Another one is from the Amazigh year called Yenayer. And the last one is from the Gregorian calendar. Snake charmers are real in Morocco. Yes, this time it's true. So odds are you will stumble upon a snake charmer when in Morocco. Though hypnotizing, cobra with a flute may seem intriguing, please think twice before supporting that practice. Another weird fact, this time related to clothing. Moroccan women wear their traditional dress once, maximum of twice. Then they have to buy a new one. If they wear it a third time, they will be tagged as out of style. So although the kaftans are very expensive, this tradition remains. So I'm wearing mine for the second time, but don't tell my mom. Moroccan houses have a particular relationship with the living rooms. So usually each home has two. One for everyday use and another one for guests. The weird thing is not about the number, but it's about not allowing anyone to use the one for the guest, unless you are a guest. So frustrating when you think about the amount of money that you invested in. Another fact that makes Morocco this time different from the world is the symbol of love. So in Morocco, the symbol of love is not the heart, but the liver. Traditionally, in Morocco, the liver represents love and romance. So if a Moroccan tells you, "You've conquered my liver," know that they are expressing affection in the Moroccan way. The sixth top fact in Morocco is that there are more cell phones than people. So some 37 million people live in Morocco, but there are at least 54 million active cell phones in the country. Smartphones are the most common way to access to internet and social media. Finally, Morocco has the magic recipe for you, argan oil, if you want to regain youth. So Morocco is the only producer and exporter of argan oil in the world. With this long list of facts, to describe Morocco shortly, I will quote His Majesty the King, the late King Hassan II, who said, "Morocco is like a tree whose roots lie in Africa, but whose leaves breathe in Europe." So through these words, he wanted to emphasize that Morocco is profoundly traditional and strongly drawn into modernity. Morocco, officially the Kingdom of Morocco, is located in North Africa. Its capital is Rabat. Morocco is one of the oldest monarchies in the world, founded in the 12th century. This royal institution guarantees the country's unity. Our national flag was adopted at the beginning of the 20th century. The dominant red is a tribute to our martyrs and symbolizes the blood that they've bravely given to recover our independence. The green color of the star refers to the land, and the star represents the country's religion and faith. The five branches symbolize the five pillars of Islam. This is our national coat of arms. The ribbon underneath has an Arabic inscription. It says, "If you glorify God, He will glorify you." So during my presentation, I will cover the topics displayed on the screen: demography, history, geography, politics, economy, culture, to close with the Royal Armed Forces. So concerning the population, Morocco is considered one of the most populous Arab countries with more than 37 million people, who are broken down into three main ethnic groups. Arab Amazigh, who represents 98%, Jewish, 0.8%, and other categories, 1.2%. Morocco's median age between male and female is almost equal. However, the country is still demographically young, with 25% of its population under the age of 15, 26% between 15 and 29 years old, and just 10.5% 60 and up. The median age of Moroccans is 30.9 years old. Morocco is a Muslim country with a Muslim majority of 99%. The official languages in the country are Arabic and Amazigh, but other languages are spoken. Darija, which is a mixture between Arabic, French, Spanish, then French, Spanish, and English. The history of a country is one of the events considered worthy of remembrance, which perfectly applies to Morocco. Morocco is a melting pot of dynasties and cultures. Several dynasties have succeeded over the years. In the classical antiquity era, Morocco experienced waves of invaders, including the first Amazigh kings, Phoenicians, Carthaginians, Romans, Vandals, Byzantines. The Berbers, or Amazigh, were the first settlers in Morocco. However, the mountain chain region remained unsubdued and stayed under the control of the native Berbers. But with the arrival of Islam, Morocco developed an independent state that kept powerful invaders at bay. The prominent dynasties that ruled Morocco were the Idrisid, the Almoravids, Muwahidin, and Sa'diyin. Morocco was the only country in North Africa not governed by the Ottoman Empire. By the mid-17th century, and after a period of decline, the Alawid dynasty reunified the nation and rebuilt an independent state. The dynasty of Alawites succeeded in giving Morocco an international identity by concluding many diplomatic treaties with contemporary powers. Morocco was put under the protectorate of France in 1912, while Spain ruled the northern and southern parts of the country. We got our independence in 1956, and in a Pacific March, we recovered the southern part of Morocco from Spain in 1975. His Majesty Mohammed VI is the 23rd ruler of this succession, ensuring the unification of the kingdom and the transmission of all religious values. Did you know that Morocco was the first nation to recognize the independence of the United States of America on December 20th of 1777? Yes, this is true. Formal U.S. relations with Morocco date from 1787, when the two nations negotiated a treaty of peace and friendship, which is still in force. It's the longest unbroken treaty in the U.S. history. According to that treaty, the Royal Moroccan Navy, then composed of fast vessels called Chebec, protected American merchant ships from pirates navigating the Mediterranean Sea. Can you believe it? Concerning Morocco's geography, Morocco overlooks the Mediterranean Sea to the north and the Atlantic Ocean to the west. It is bordered by Algeria in the east, Spain in the north, and Mauritania to the south. It covers more than 700,000 square kilometers and coast of 3,500 kilometers, and it's only 9 miles from sea from Spain and Gibraltar. A rugged mountainous interior and large portions of desert characterize Morocco. Inland, the Atlas mountain chain runs through the country's center, between which lie vast plateaus of grasslands. The terrain is such that the coastal plains are rich and comprise the backbone of agriculture. Forests cover about 12% of the land, while arable land accounts for 18%. Tidrine Mountain and Toubkal are the highest peaks with an elevation of 8,054 feet and 13,671 feet. These mountains are the home of several plants and animal species that are unique in Africa. And in the higher elevations of the massive Toubkal, snow regularly falls, allowing winter sports. Morocco has also 3,500 kilometers of beaches, so you can move from kayaking in the Mediterranean Sea to surfing on the Atlantic coast. Morocco is finally characterized by its desert called Sahara. It spreads in the south. The dunes rise to 200 meters. The dunes of El Chebbi are the most visited by tourists. Due to the wide variety of terrain, the climate of Morocco, like its topography, also varies with locations. Mediterranean climate to more extreme in the interior and the south. All in all, the temperature is moderate and subtropical, cooled by breezes of the Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea. So this diverse landscape mixed with that historical background makes Morocco one of the most popular destinations in the world, with more than 10 million tourists each year, I will leave you with a short video that depicts that diversity. Into politics in Morocco. So regarding politics in Morocco, the political regime established in the country is constitutional, democratic, parliamentary, and social monarchy. The first constitution was adopted in 1962, and it was amended 5 times. The country adopted the last one in 2011 in response to the protests that took place earlier in the year demanding democratic reforms. As any democratic country, Morocco adheres to the separation of powers and uses diplomacy as a main instrument of power in its external relationships. Morocco has opted for regionalism, which is equivalent to federalism, with a gradual transfer of power since 2017. Education, justice, and healthcare are the central focus of the Moroccan government. In Morocco, education is free from primary school to getting your PhD if you're willing to. Justice is free unless you opt for alternative dispute resolutions, and all the population benefits from healthcare, free healthcare. With regard to its economy, Morocco, though a developing country, has capitalized on its proximity to Europe and relatively low labor costs to work towards building a diverse, open, market-oriented economy. Key sectors of the economy include agriculture, tourism, aerospace, automotive, phosphates, and textiles. To increase exports, Morocco entered into a bilateral free trade agreement with the US in 2006 and an advanced status agreement with the European Union in 2008, as well as several African countries. The agriculture, fishing, and forestry sectors employ about 45% of the workforce. In 2022, Morocco's exports of agriculture and related products were $10.5 billion, while its imports were $11.7 billion. The European Union is Morocco's primary trading partner, accounting for about 60% of Morocco's agriculture exports. Fisheries is also developed in Morocco, with more than 240 commercial species. Our primary customers are the European Union and Japan. Morocco has also increased investment in its ports, transportation, and industrial infrastructure to position itself as a hub for business throughout Africa. In addition, with 75% of the world's phosphates reserves, the country is the first exporter and the third producer after USA and Russia. New ports and free trade zones most visibly illustrate the industrial development strategies and infrastructure improvements. From another perspective, and in order to reduce its dependence on energy imports, Morocco has considered some viable options, the use of wind and solar power. The objective is to increase the contribution of renewable energies to electricity production by 72% in 2025. For the record, Morocco held the United Nations Climate Conference in 2016. The Moroccan culture is a rare species. Moroccan culture is deeply rooted in Islam, but also contemporary. Moroccans value family, honor, dignity, generosity, hospitality, and self-control. Moroccans believe it is important to be neat, well-groomed, and appropriately dressed. The national garment is the djellaba for men, or djabador, and kaftan or takshita for women, worn for special occasions. Besides, Morocco is an ethnically diverse country with a rich culture and civilization. The music of Morocco ranges and differs according to the various areas of the country. Morocco is home to Andalusian classical music brought from the Iberic Peninsula. Gnawa music is considered as a mystical music, and it was gradually brought to Morocco by sub-Saharan Africans and later become part of the national Moroccan tradition. The Isawa is a religious and mystical brotherhood folklore, and Ahwesh is the name of a famous Amazigh groups in Moroccan folklore. Handicrafts are also part of the Moroccan heritage. They are all practical, valuable instruments used for centuries and are still employed at home as everyday clothing items. The industry has expanded with the tourist trade. Last but not least, when famous actors are tired from Hollywood or Bollywood, they look towards that city to film their movies. The Mummy, Braveheart are some examples. So now, if I have to convince you more about the beauty of Morocco from the US side this time, I would say, Disneyland Florida has to choose 7 countries worldwide for its best theme park in Orlando. Morocco is one of them. To close up this culture chapter, I will quote the Moroccan cuisine. Moroccan cuisine is rich in both history and flavor. It takes great advantage of the natural bounty of a country where eating is more of a social ritual. Tagine and couscous are best known, and the Moroccan tea served with cookies is a feast. For the joke, one of my American friends calls it the Moroccan whiskey. So you can drink it as much as you want without getting arrested for the DUI. A unique characteristic of Moroccan cuisine is its traditional protocol. So you cannot eat without following a particular way of serving, kind of etiquette à la marocaine. Let me show you what I'm talking about.
مازال ما نسيت الجلساتي فاس خلعه وزريع الكاس ولا عين الكحلا يا ناس يجرحوا الكوبيد كل شي بالقاعدة مع غزالي زين العبسة تقول صاري وسط المرصة مشينا نوري أكل شي بالقاعدة
So after this protocol demonstration, and as a good CGSE student, let me take you back to the military universe and talk about the Royal Armed Forces. The Royal Armed Forces was established in 1956. His Majesty the King is the Royal Armed Forces Supreme Commander and Chief of Staff. He appoints to military positions and may delegate this right. The core responsibility of the Royal Armed Forces is to defend the Moroccan Kingdom from attack upon its territory and to secure its land, air, and maritime borders. The Royal Armed Forces must also maintain the capacity to support civilian authorities in periods of national emergency, such as in the wake of catastrophic disasters, border surveillance and fighting against cross-border threat, counter-terrorism in coordination with other security forces as part of Hadar counter-terrorism arrangements, humanitarian assistance, including deployment of medical and surgical field hospitals, and finally, peacekeeping operations. The Royal Armed Forces is organized in bureaus and directions, as well as the Army, Navy, and Air Headquarters, with 3 commands, South, East, and North. The first bureau is responsible for personnel manning and human resources policies for NCOs and soldier staff. The Department of Officers is in charge of officer manning. The second bureau is responsible for managing, monitoring cooperation activities and intel. The third bureau conducts operational planning, coordinates movements and employment of forces, and is also responsible for training. The fourth bureau is in charge of the acquisition and maintenance of defense equipment and logistics. And the fifth bureau is in charge of detecting, preventing, countering any risk that may affect the Royal Armed Forces security, classified documentation, and staff morale. The Army components includes a set of branches and services whose missions are to ensure the security and integrity of the homeland at all times and in all circumstances. Participate into disaster relief and rescue operations nationally and regionally, and perform some public service tasks and contributing to peace building support. The Royal Air Forces are responsible for monitoring national airspace and participating in intel operations, ensuring fire and logistic support and projection of forces, managing and coordinating space operations, and participating in disaster relief operations. The mission of the Royal Navy include maritime defense of the territory and national interests in the sea, guaranteeing free access to the kingdom ports according to the Moroccan regulation, supporting and sustaining the Royal Armed Forces units, and performing specific public service tasks. Another specificity about the Moroccan Army is the Royal Gendarmerie, which is a special police within the Army. Its tasks consist of exercising the function of the military judicial police, supporting national security operations and countering terrorism initiative, providing assistance and relief operation, and countering drug trafficking and illegal immigration. Apart from its traditional commitment to preserving peace and security, Morocco actively contributes to peacekeeping operations. Currently, Morocco stands in the top 20 on the list of countries contributing troops. Since the beginning of the Royal Armed Forces participation, more than 75,000 soldiers have contributed to the different UN missions. More than 2,700 UN peacekeepers have been deployed as a part of the UN mission in the Democratic Republic of Congo since 2010, and in the Central African Republic since December 2013. Others are deployed within the different UN missions, either as military observers or staff officers. Furthermore, to enhance interoperability, the Royal Armed Forces conduct several joint exercises with key partners such as US and NATO. I can cite the partnership with the Eura National Guard initiated in 2003. It focuses on tactical emergency casualty care, crisis management and humanitarian assistance, air refueling, and soft training. The latest example is the Africa Lion exercise, one of the significant cooperation capstones between US and Morocco. This exercise allows to the development of operational capabilities and reinforcement of the interoperability. This exercise includes tactical training, fight against violent extremist organizations, air and maritime exercise, as well as having a field medical and surgical hospital deployment to the benefit of the local population. Participants from NATO, African countries, and multinational observers attended the 2022 edition, so I will leave you with an extract from that exercise.
I really do think we both get better. The Ghanaians and us, we have an opportunity to really learn from each other.
Today we got to shoot missiles.
We've had multiple different exercises to help us build and get us ready for African Lion 22. And I feel like coming here and actually getting everything done has been pretty cool and really nice to see all the hard work paying off.
So with that last video, my presentation comes to an end. But before closing, a takeaway slide. 5 things to remember about Morocco. Morocco is located in North Africa. It has a rich culture. It's a cosmopolitan country. Its people speak several languages. And finally, it's not all camels and desert. Thank you for your attention. I hope to see you soon visiting my country. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much for that amazing presentation. It was a pleasure to be in with you and learn more about your country and culture, history, and the enduring presence of not only your country to the U.S. over the years, but also on the global stage. On behalf of the International Military Student Office and the entire Security Cooperation Enterprise, we thank you for letting us be a part of your experience through this insightful engagement. For your efforts, we present to you the coveted CGSC Coin of Excellence. Coveted. If everybody would like to give her one more round of applause. The International Military Student Office would like to recognize Major Jirari for her work. She did all of the food that you're going to see in the atrium. It's going to be quite a feat, and it's quite an amazing endeavor that she got. We also would like to thank our media team up in the booth that's been supporting us throughout the rehearsals, and also our PAO teams that did a stupendous job of getting all the information out so that you could join us today. We also would like to take a moment to thank Major Jirari's student ambassador, who's up driving in the booth, Major Kashila Stanford, and also her staff group, 13 Alpha. You hear? Excellent. And, of course, Hind's family, who helped her throughout the process to make this Know Your World presentation everything that it could be. And a heartfelt thanks to our international sponsors who are here, our CGSC faculty, the Army U staff, and of course our local communities. We do appreciate your partnership for coming and joining us for these events, and also all of our partners around the world, as this is streamed all over, and her family was watching in their hometown at about 11:30 to 12 o'clock at night to see their daughter present Know Your World Morocco. So with that, we have another Know Your World, March 22nd, 2023, from our strategic partner from Cyprus. We look forward to seeing you then. And at this time, if you would like to exit the auditorium and go to the atrium to meet with Major Jirari and her family, please do enjoy a small taste of the delicious cuisine and have a very blessed day.